Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another fun, fast project. So let's get cracking. Friends, once again, I am on Reddit, and a user has a question how to fill in this hole. So I do not have the original part, but friends, let me just show you a couple techniques you could use. Of course, for me, step one is going to be create new 3D design. Now, like I said, I do not have that original shape, but watch this. If we take out a cylinder, make it as smooth as we can, I'm going to just shift, stretch, and squeeze. This is the rounded edge that user had. And then watch this. If we bring out a hole on both sides, and I'm going to shrink this down so it's going to get cut. Control D, move this to the other side. I'm going to shift select these two and I'm going to group them. And what that does is it lets me align them with L. And once we group, we have just created that user's design. I'll skip back. Check it out. It's kind of like a football with cutoff ends. Now you note, hey, it's not hollow. Well, watch this. I'm going to squeeze it just a tiny bit more, trying to get it exactly like that user had it. And I'm going to export as an SVG. Friends, I'm going to save this crazy name out here in my downloads. And then, friends, I'm going to re-import that shape. When we bring it back, I'm going to just select the art. I'm going to keep the measurements, and I'm going to choose import. Instead of orange, it comes in brown. And this is why I did it. If we choose outer line, bingo, we've got our shape. Now, it made a line width of 5. I'm going to cut this back to 1. I'm going to bump the quality up. And you can see we have all of a sudden got that user's exact design. Stretch it out to whatever length you wanted, and you don't have a hole. Now, friends, I do want to show you how to solve that user's problem. So that user was working with an imported STL, so they could not ungroup, fix, and play with it. So I'm going to simulate that real quick. We'll just pretend this is an STL. I'm going to put this hole in it. Let's select those two. Choose L for a line. I'm going to put it up on the top. I'm going to put it in the center, and I'm going to put it in the center. Control up raises that up a couple more. And if I do Control G, boom, we've got the user's original problem where they've got this shape and they've got a hole in it. Well, here's a way to fix that. If you do Control D and you cut off this entire section, so I'm going to just slide that across. Notice because of cruising, I couldn't set it on the shape. I'm going to raise the hole up. I'm going to stretch it back. I'm grabbing this black handle back here. And I'm going to make sure I cut in front of the hole. If I do Control G to group, I can now take these two pieces. Let's do L for a line. I'm going to make that one the boss. And I want center. I'm going to look at this from a corner. And I want center. And check it out. That was luck that that lined up. If I needed to stretch it more, I could. And when I take those two and do Control G to group, boom, your part is solved. So friends, two ways to solve it. You could have done it by cutting and moving it. Friends, you can also just create shapes in Tinkercad and use that wicked cool SVG tool. One other thing I'm going to show you quick because I do this for my screenshots. You can set the background color to any color you pick. You can also shut off the grid and click over here so the project looks much more nifty. Finally, friends, I just want to highlight how cool Reddit is and thank this user for the question. Friends, I want to take a moment to remind you about my website, HLModTech.com. I've got a page dedicated to Tinkercad with tons of amazing categories. Below that, you will find my day one favorites, useful starters, and then also Tinkercad essentials. Friends, I do also want to mention the sweet built-in messaging tool. You can click that button, add your question, comment, or suggestion, and reach out to me almost instantly. I also want to take a moment to highlight the Tinkercad community Discord. As you can see, friends, we have more than 700 members, and it is a fantastic place to talk everything Tinkercad. Finally, friends, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HL ModTech. Don't forget, you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button. And last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.